Joe Lieberman, a former senator and vice presidential nominee, has passed away at the age of 82. The cause was complications from a fall, according to his family. And look, this was unexpected. I mean, especially because lately, if Lieberman ever came up on the show, it was in the context of an organization that he was the co-chair of, known as No Labels. And No Labels seemed to really just be a front meant to push Biden to a more pro-corporate agenda. And so I've got no love for No Labels. I also, looking at Joe Lieberman's political career, had no love for Joe Lieberman, which we'll get to in just a moment. But before I get to those details, John, any initial thoughts?
Yes, I will say I was blindsided by it, as you were, as I think most people will. He was a person who, you know, if you've been following American politics for a long time, there was a time when he was one of the players that you'd hear about all the time. Mm-hmm. But most people probably have not thought about him for literally years. He was 82, he passed away. It is sad when people pass away, and his family likely knows him in a different way than we do or ever could. And that is sad, and that's for them to deal with. But we're a political show, so screw Joe Lieberman and basically everything he ever stood for. Not everything, there's one or two things that are okay.
That you would care about deeply, which we'll get to.
Sure, there are a few things.
Yeah.
But he was not only wrong on some major issues, he was an incredibly frustrating person in American politics. He was Kyrsten Sinema before Kyrsten Sinema was. Mm-hmm. He wasn't quite as dishonest as her because he never presented himself as like a progressive or anything like
that's
that.
True.
She lied to us more. But he was elevated to positions he should have never been in, considering how unrepresentative he was of even Democrats back 15 years ago. He single-handedly stopped aid going to literally millions of people who desperately needed it. He had a net terrible effect on America, and I'm very, very glad that we don't have more politicians like him.
So let's get into that net negative effect, including his unwavering support for invading Iraq in 2003. Even after it had become abundantly clear that Saddam Hussein had no weapons of mass destruction, he continued supporting the war in Iraq, which is incredible. He was a vice presidential nominee when Al Gore was running. He was, I can't believe he was Al Gore's running mate, but he was.
It makes no sense.
In 2000.
It's before my time covering the news, but it makes no sense.
And he also, for whatever reason, endorsed John McCain over Barack Obama back in 2008. In fact, he was so promoted John McCain so vociferously that McCain even considered him as his running mate. Mm-hmm. But ultimately, they decided it's probably not going to work out too well for McCain. So instead, he's going to go with someone with more gravitas, like Sarah Palin. And that worked out great for McCain. Mm-hmm. Now, according to this lengthy obit written by the Washington Post, Lieberman's full-throated support for the 2003 invasion of Iraq and the increasingly unpopular war that followed doomed Mr. Lieberman's bid for the Democratic presidential nomination in 2004 and led to his rejection by Connecticut Democrats when he sought his fourth Senate term in 2006. So,
I remember that, yeah. Mm-hmm. Being from Connecticut myself.
Yeah, so tell me more because you were on the ground.
A lot of mainstream media don't give you honest news. We do. You know why? Because of you. Paid membership on YouTube makes all the difference. Hit the join button below and you become the hero that sustains us.
Look, Connecticut is a weird state politically. There is like an element of very like conservative financial companies and stuff like that in Connecticut. But it's a pretty lib state, honestly. I don't know, maybe it's not like LA or whatever, but it's pretty to the left, okay? Maybe not as much as Vermont, but in that kind of vein. And so the positions that he was staking out for years leading up to this were wildly unpopular, particularly among young people in Connecticut at that point. I know it's hard to believe. I was a college student around that time. And so they put up Ned Lamont against him. He challenged him. It was an incredibly unlikely primary win that this guy, who was not particularly well known on the state level, let alone the national level, took down Joe Lieberman in the primary. It was crazy. It was almost like an AOC sort of thing at that point. He was a guy, Ned Lamont, who was really trying to court young voters and represent them and everything, and he beat them. And then Joe Lieberman did a thing where he ran as an independent. And because of the way elections work, that meant that some of the Democrats went over to him and there were some independent voters and there was a Republican. So the real Democrat got screwed over and the guy who'd been rejected by Democrats won.
Yeah.
So he gave a middle finger in his final days as an elected official to his state.
Listen, as
Joe Lieberman.
As someone who was not a fan of Joe Lieberman, I totally understand and would have been part of the group of Democratic voters who were furious about the maneuvering that he engaged in. Mm-hmm. With that said, pretty clever maneuvering.
Oh yeah, no, it's like the Adam Schiff thing. Like, it's not illegal. He can do it. It just sucks and it's anti-democratic, I would say, fundamentally.
Absolutely. So before I get to what he did right and what we agreed with him doing, I do want to focus on more of what he did that I did not like. So look, Lieberman really prided himself on being the kind of Democrat who was willing to reach across the aisle, which overall, it's not that I'm against that. It's that he did so on policy issues that I do not agree with, right? So for instance, he did generally vote along with Democrats, but sided with Republicans on cutting the capital gains tax, funding vouchers that parents could use to send their children to private schools, which basically strips public schools of resources and funnels the money into private schools instead, and placing new restrictions on consumer lawsuits against corporations. So that's who Lieberman was. He loved insurance companies. He loved special interests. He would look out for them.
Kind
of
a Connecticut Democrat. Yeah.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. He was, you know, deeply religious, a Jewish member of Congress. In fact, I believe he was the first prominent Jewish vice presidential candidate.
Yeah.
And he did emphasize morality quite a bit throughout his career, which is a funny way of putting it when you consider, like, that's how the Washington Post is putting it, which I find hilarious when the guy went against Americans, went against consumers to make it more difficult for them to sue corporations if they had been wronged by said corporations. Like, how is that moral?
It's moral, like Trump is populist. It's because they use the word, that's it.
And you know, as you all know, he was also the co-chair for No Labels, which again, I really do believe was meant to push Biden to a more pro-corporate agenda. It was like, I always saw No Labels as more of a empty threat to Biden. Like, yeah, you know, if we run a ticket that has a Democrat and a Republican who are willing to work together, that might strip you of some of your voters and you might lose. So think about it. More pro corporate policies, please. He was also influential in shaping Obama's healthcare initiative, ensuring that there would be no public option, meaning that there would be no government run option that would be far more affordable for Americans who can't afford Obamacare.
He threatened to filibuster it if they tried to pass it.
Exactly.
He screwed over people and made healthcare harder for them to achieve. Very moral. Very moral person.
Super moral. Now, let's get to what I think you would like about his political career. Because when it came to the environment, he did do some good things. So he built an activist record by going after polluters, consumer ripoffs, and child support delinquents.
Okay, I didn't know that last part.
Yeah, the consumer ripoffs I find funny because, again, he pushed really hard to make it more difficult for consumers to sue corporations that had wronged them. But nonetheless, one of his earliest achievements was having a leadership role in the bipartisan amendment in 1990 of the Clear Air Act, beefing up federal regulations of pollutants.
Yes.
And that's it, that's the only good thing I could find.
No, so look, the way I remember it, I think he was helpful in helping to end Don't Ask, Don't Tell. That's the credit I was gonna give him on that.
I'll give him credit for that.
I don't remember 100% for sure. Again, a lot of this was before my time actually. Like, I follow politics as a person, but I wasn't in the news. So it's not to say that there are not any things that a guy who was in government for many, many, many years didn't do that were okay. I think that it would be fair to remember Joe Lieberman as a perfectly acceptable Republican senator. He's one of the good Republican senators. As a Democratic senator from a fairly liberal state, not so good. We deserved better, in the same way that California has often deserved better from its representation. He's the sort of Democrat that I would say did a lot of work to make regular people not trust Democrats. He's a guy that, like, on some social issues is okay, but when the chips were down, he's gonna line up behind the already wealthy and advantaged by our economic system. Mm-hmm. Always reliably. He's gonna line up for the rich, for corporations, and he's gonna get regular people, including regular Democrats, to not fundamentally trust them. And that's why when, like, you see the ads for No Labels go up, and it's like, I saw it on our B-roll, the not left, not right, forward. It's like the biggest lie. Not forward. Here. Yeah, right here.
Quo.
Here's good, actually. Let's stay here. Let's not go anywhere else, because I'm winning here. I'm rich here. Anywhere else, I might not be winning. So let's stay right here. And all of you who are not right here with us rich people, and you don't have health insurance, or you're being screwed over by a corporation in some way, except maybe you get cleaner air, then you guys can just sit and spin, because we're doing well the way it is. That's who he was as a politician.
Totally. Yeah, so look, I won't be missing him as a politician. I don't think that he really operated based on what he thought would be best for the country, even though he claimed to do so. He had some bright marks in his political record, as we just mentioned, but there were a lot of negative marks as well. And so, look, I don't want to be too, I actually don't like being too harsh after someone passes away, unless they were particularly awful. I can't say that Lieberman, especially when you consider the current political landscape, was particularly awful. I think he was indicative of a class of politicians that have now dominated politics in America. Okay, those who have been effectively legally bribed by corporations to maintain the status quo, those who will lie to your face as they are campaigning and then immediately switch gears as soon as they're elected. And I find those politicians disgusting. And you're right, they sow distrust among the American electorate. The largest group of voters in America happen to be non-voters, because they don't believe in the system, because the system hasn't actually done, in their minds, much for them. Elections haven't actually led to better conditions on the ground for a lot of Americans. And I think that politicians like Lieberman are to blame for that. And so, that's really all I have to say about Lieberman. The other thing I'll say is, he was 82, he died from complications of a fall. Our current president is 81.
Oh, I wasn't sure exactly where you're going with that, but.
Our current president, yeah, who insists on running for re-election, it's too late. That's it. That's the option that we have right now. We have Biden, Kamala, on the Democratic side, and then we have Trump and whoever his running mate is gonna be on the Republican side.
And another option would be wrap Biden in bubble wrap, just in case. I think he's more hardy than Joe Lieberman, but I understand your concern.
John.
Joe Lieberman back in like 2006, I think, was a fairly frail man.
There is nothing hardy about Joe Biden.
Okay.
Let's not be delusional.
Okay.
But that's the world that we're living in right now. Where you know, if you're in the news and if you either lean on the left or are on the left, you're supposed to lie to your audience and pretend as though Biden being as old as he is not an issue. It's an issue. It's a huge issue. And again, he's 81 years old. His running mate is Kamala Harris, and she's been pretty terrible as VP. Very likely, if he passes away during his term, she's gonna be the president. She can't give a public speech.
Well, and what she stands for, I don't particularly know. How it might have evolved from when she was running for president,
I don't particularly know.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.